students. Today's lesson, factors contributing for the aging process. The aim of lesson is to understand aging process and factors contributing for the aging process in general and also in Indian perspective. On the completion of this lesson, you should able to gain the knowledge on issues relating to aging process, to develop knowledge on the measures of old age, to study and understand the different types of age structures, to analyze factors contributing for the aging process. What is aging process? Aging is the process of becoming older. The term refers especially to human beings, many animals and fungi, whereas for example bacteria, perennial plants and some simple animals are potentially immortal. In the broader sense, aging can refer to single cells within an organism which have ceased dividing or to the population of a species. The process of aging can be measured by different methods. The appropriate means will be measured is the increasing proportion of the aged in society. The society involved in the process of aging experiences transformations that are not only of a demographic nature. In such a society, everything is changing: economic, social, and political conditions. Measures of the aging process. The aging process can be measured in many ways, and the following types are discussed in this heading. First one is broad age structure, second one is median age, third one is index of aging, fourth one is dependency ratio. Broad age structure. The broad age structure is any population reflect the changing composition of children 0 to 14, adults of working ages 15 to 59, and the elderly person 60 plus. Median age. The median age is defined as the age which divides a population into two equal halves. It can therefore reflect the aging phenomenon as it determines whether a given population is young or old. Median age increases faster with the fertility transition, which reduces the number of children. For India, it is computed as 20 years for 1981 and it is expected to reach 28 years by 2021. Index of aging. Index of aging is defined as the ratio of population about 60 years of age to the population in the age group 0 to 14. It is interpreted as the number of persons above age 60 per 100 children below age 14 years. Dependency ratio. The dependency ratio refers to the ratio of the population below 14 years of age and above 60 years of age to the population in working ages 15 to 59 years. This also exhibits the changing age structure of the population in relation to the young and old dependency ratios. Different types of age structures. Types of population composition by age are very important accomplishment and have great importance for the history of our science and for the history of demographic conditions. The beginnings of discussion on the types of age structure are inseparably connected with the Swedish demographer Gustav Sundberg. He proposed three important types of age structures by age and a pertinent thesis, according to which the age structure is characterized by either constant or variable factors. Age structure gives a clear picture of how a country transitions from high fertility to low fertility rate. The broad base of the pyramid means the majority of population lies between ages 0 to 14, which tells us that the fertility rate of the country is high and above population sub-replacement fertility level. The older population is declining over time due to a shorter life expectancy of 60 years. However, there are still more females than males in these ranges since women have a longer life expectancy. As basic types of age structure of the population, Sundberg mentions the following: the progressive type, the stationary type, the regressive type. Progressive type. This age structure is very wide at the younger ages. characteristic of countries with high birth rate and low life expectancy. The population is said to be fast growing, and the size of each birth cohort gets larger than the size of the previous year. Stationary type. This type can be described as stationary if the percentages of population, age and sex remains constant over time. Stationary population is when a population contains equal birth rates and death rates. Regressive type. This age structure is narrowed at the bottom. The population is generally older on average as the country has long life expectancy, a low death rate but also a low birth rate. However, the percentage of younger population are extremely low. This can cause issues with the dependency ratio of the population. This pyramid is more common when immigrants are factored out. This is a typical pattern for a very developed country. A high level of education, easy access to and incentive to use birth control, good health care and few negative environmental factors. As per available data, there has been a gradual decline in the share of population in the age group 0 to 14 from 41.2% to 29.5% during 1971 to 2011, whereas the proportion of economically active population 15 to 59 years has increased from 53.4% to 62.5% during 1971 to 2011. The age group 0-14 is further subcategorized into the age groups 0 to 4 and 5 to 9 and 10 to 14. It is observed that for most of the age groups, male-female differences in the age distribution of population are negligible except in the combined age group of 0 to 14, 15 to 59 and 60 above and 65 plus. The proportion of young children in the age group 0 to 4 and also the proportion of population in the age group 0 to 14 are higher in rural areas than in urban areas, both for male and female. Process of population aging. Population aging, the process by which older individuals come to form a proportionately larger share of the total population, is one of the most distinctive demographic events of the contemporary world. Initially experienced in the more developed countries, the process is now rapidly approaching the developing world. Although not a global phenomenon yet, various predictions indicate that population aging is going to become a major global issue in the years to come. For most of the nations, regardless of their geographic location or developmental stage, there are two notable aspects of the global aging process. One is progressive demographic aging of the elderly people, and the other is about feminization of aging. The rapid growth of older population has an identical importance in public policy. Population aging is the most significant result of the process known as demographic transition. Reduction of fertility leads to a decline in the proportion of the young in the population. Reduction of mortality means a longer lifespan for individuals. Population aging involves a shift from high mortality, high fertility to low mortality, low fertility, and consequently an increased proportion of older people in the total population. Improvement of public health and medical services leads to substantial control of specific infectious diseases, which has a great effect in reducing mortality rates. Improved sanitation, better mental health and child care facilities reduce the infant mortality. On the other hand, in the urban areas, family planning methods are greatly accepted, which reduces the fertility rate. Factors contributing to the aging process. To understand the demographic factors that cause population aging, demographers often refer to a stable population. This population model assumes that age-specific fertility and mortality rates remain constant over time, and this results in a population with an age distribution that stabilizes and eventually becomes time invariant as well. Thus, India is expected to have a faster decline in fertility in the immediate future compared to mortality, because the latter is already at a low level. Hence, the aging process in India will be faster than certain other developing countries. Moreover, the transition from high to fertility is expected to narrow the age structure at its base, broadening the same at the top. In addition, important in life expectancy will allow older people to survive further, thus intensifying the aging process. So many factors are contributing to the aging process. Decisive factors affecting the aging process are changes in fertility rates. Second one is a progressive declining in mortality. Third one is dependency ratio. Fourth one is demographic transition. And fifth one is migratory and immigratory movements. Sixth one is war destructions, where all the factors mentioned above operate simultaneously and affects the aging process. Let me discuss about the factors which are contributing for the aging process in details. Changes in fertility rate. Fertility is defined as the average expected number of children to be born by a woman during her entire reproductive span under a given age schedule of fertility. The total fertility rate, sometimes also called the fertility rate, period total fertility rate, or total period fertility rate of a population, is the average number of children that would be born to a woman over her lifetime. If she were to experience the exact current age-specific fertility rates through her lifetime and she were to survive from birth through the end of her reproductive life, it is obtained by summing the single year age-specific rates at a given time. The crude birth rate at all India level had declined from 36.9 in 1971 to 33.9 in 1981, registering a fall of about 8% during 1991 to 2012. The decline has been about 26.8% from 29.5 to 21.8. The total fertility rate has declined from 5.2 to 4.5 during 1971 to 1981 and from 3.6 to 2.4 during 1991 to 2012. Age of women is an important factor affecting the fertility levels. The fertility reaches the peak in the age group 20 to 24 and declines thereafter, irrespective of the place of residence. ASFR curve for urban areas falls under the ASFR curve of rural areas. Rural ASFR curves has declined very steeply after attaining peak for age 20 to 24, whereas urban ASFR curves has gradually declined up to the age 25 to 29 after attaining peak at age group 20 to 24. The TFR in rural areas has declined from 5.4 to 2.6 from 1971 to 2012, whereas corresponding decline in urban areas has been from 4.1 to 1.8 during the same period. In 2012, around 73% of the deliveries were institutional, which includes government as well as private hospitals. The percentage of institutional deliveries in urban areas is 92.0 as against about 67.9% recorded in rural areas. The influence of changes in fertility rates on population aging is perhaps less than that of mortality rates. Everything else constant, however, a fertility decline reduces the size of the most recent birth cohorts relative to the previous birth cohorts. Hence, reducing the size of the youngest age groups relatively to that of the older ones. Mortality rate. Mortality rate is a measure of the number of deaths in some population scaled to the size of that population per unit time. Mortality rate is typically expressed in units of deaths per 1,000 individuals per year. Thus, a mortality rate of 9.5 in a population of 1 lakh would mean 950 deaths per year in that entire population, or 0.95 out of the total. Mortality is one of the basic components of population change, and related data is essential for demographic studies and public health administration. It is the principal ingredient for population projections and life tables. Does the decline in mortality affect the population age structure and the aging process? Yes, it is affect the age structure and aging process. India provides a example of countries having many gaps in the registration of deaths. From a theoretical point of view, there are three possible results of a decrease in mortality. First one is a decline in mortality due to a preponderance of lives saved in the younger age groups, which in the end results in the rejuvenation of the population. Second one is a decline in mortality due to a preponderance of human lives saved in the old age groups, which in the end results in the aging of population. Third one is an equal decline in mortality in both younger and old age groups, which does not affect the structure of the population by age. Sample registration system has continued to provide data for estimating various mortality measures since its inception. The crude death rate at all India level has declined significantly from 14.29 to 12.5 during 1971 to 1981 and thereafter from 9.8 to 7.1 during 91 to 2011. The decline has been steeper in rural areas as compared to urban areas. The infant mortality rate, which plays an important role in health planning, has shown a considerable decline from 129% to 1,000 live births in 1971 to 110 in 1981 and from 80 in 1991 to 44 in 2011. The child mortality rate has depicted a perceptible decline from 51.9 in 1971 to 41.2 in 1981 and from 26.5 in 1991 to 12.2 in 2011. Old age dependency ratio. In India, generally persons aged 15 to 59 years are supposed to form the population of working ages and at age 60. People generally retire or withdraw themselves from work. Thus, the old age dependency ratio is defined as the number of persons in the age group 60 or more per 100 persons in the age group 15 to 59 years. Old age dependency ratio in India from 1971 to 2011. The old age dependency ratio shows an increasing trend and the ratio has risen from 10.9% in 1961 to 14.2% in 2011. Demographic transition. Population aging is related to the demographic transition, that is the process that lead a society from a demographic regime characterized by high rates of fertility and mortality to another one with lower fertility and mortality rates. In the course of this transition, the age structure is subjected to different influences. In the typical sequences, the transition begins with success in preventing infectious and parasitic diseases that benefit infants and young children most. The resulting improvement in life expectancy at birth occurs while fertility tends to remain unchanged, thereby producing large birth cohorts and expanding proportion of children relative to adults. Other things being equal, this initial decline in mortality generates a younger population age structure. Migration and immigration. The rate of population aging may also be modulated by migration and immigration, usually slow down population aging because immigrants tend to be younger and have more children. On the other hand, immigration of working age adults accelerates the population aging as it is observed now in some Caribbean nations. Population aging in some countries is also accelerated by immigration of elderly retirees from other countries and return migration of former immigrants who are above the average population age. Some demographers expect that migration will have a more prominent role in population aging in the future, particularly in low fertility countries with stable or declining population size. The effects of migration on population aging are usually stronger in smaller populations because of higher relative population of migrants in such populations. The data on migration by last residents in India as per Census 2011 shows that 45.36 crore Indians in India are migrants now settled in a place different from their previous residence. In 2001, the figure stood at 31.45 crore, Most people, 49%, migrants from marriage. Lesser Indians are now relocating for work and employment, 10.2% in 2011, down from 14.4% in 2001. From 2001 to 2011, marriages was the dominant reason for migration among women, as was the case in previous two decades. Around 21.7 crore of the 31.2 crores female migrants, 69.7%, 65.9% women in 1981 to 1991 and 64.9% in 1991 to 2001 migrated. Migration on account of change of residence by women after marriage constitutes a significant proportion of these migrants. War destruction. War is a state of armed conflict between states or societies. It is generally characterized by extreme aggression, destruction, and mortality using regular or irregular military forces. Warfare refers to the common activities and characteristics of types of war or of wars in general. Total war is a warfare that is not restricted to purely legitimate military targets and can result in massive civilian or other non-combatant suffering and casualties. War destruction is one of the important factors contributing for the aging process. Post-war effects are widely spread and can be long-term or short-term. Soldiers experience war differently than civilians, although either suffer in times of war, and women, older people and children suffer unspeakable atrocities in particular. In the past decade, up to 2 million of those killed in armed conflicts were children, and it was affect the future generations and the aging process. The demographic effects of war naturally vary with the organization, conduct and objectives of the conflict. The effects of their removal from the population on the birth rate seem not to have been very significant before the 20th century. Prior to 19th century, in Europe, prices in general prosperity were associated with increased fertility. The huge loss suffered in the major battles of World War I, European elites to speak of a lost generation of young men whose sweethearts remain unmarried, but it is difficult to document the statement. While statements range widely, plausible size of the military and civilian death toll would be around 8.5 million in World War I and 40 million in World War II. A difficult facing the analyst seeking to quantify the demographic effects of war is calculating mortality associated with war but not directly caused by losses on the field of battle. The Swedish armies alone may have destroyed up to 2,000 castles, 18,000 villages and 1,500 towns in Germany, one-third of all German towns. These numbers usually include both the deaths of military personnel, which are the direct results of battle or other military wartime actions, as well as the wartime war-related deaths of civilians, which are the results of war-induced epidemics, diseases, famines, atrocities, genocide, etc. A major emerging demographic issue of the 21st century is the aging of population as an inevitable consequence of the demographic transition experienced by most countries. Across the world, declining fertility and increased longevity have jointly resulted in higher number and proportions of the older persons 60 years and above. Worldwide, there were 901 million people aged 60 years or over in 2015, an increase of 48% over the 607 million older persons globally in 2000. By 2030, the number of people in the world aged 60 years or over is projected to grow by 56% to 1.4 billion, and by 2050, the global population of older persons is projected to more than double its size in 2015, reaching nearly 2.1 billion. General conclusions about the effect of fertility on the age structure of populations can be drawn from the Indian demographic forecast for the year 1961 to 2011, which shows a significant effect on the aging process in India. Simultaneously, all the factors like mortality rate, migration and dependency ratio and demographic transition effects in a large to the future development of age structure in India. This demographic transition results that growing older generations will affect the socio-economic development of the country. With the increasing trend of nuclear families in the society and with favored children in a family, the care of older persons in the families gets increasingly difficult. Social security spending of government also increases with the increase of old age population due to increased longevity of life, pension bills increase. On the other hand, lesser people of working age means lower number of working people, leading to lower tax base and lower tax collection. Every individual should be responsible for this impact on the society at large.